Greetings, everyone, and welcome once again to the Baptist Bread and Scripture Song broadcast for this 9th day of July, and it is Tuesday, 2024, and the title of this little message and poem is titled, He is With Us, and there is no particular author for this poem here, so I'll read you the passage here from Isaiah 43:2, and we might as well look at the entirety of Isaiah 43 to get some context, and then we'll read this poem here, written by Anonymous, and then submitted by Dr. Wayne Hudson Azle, that's A-Z-L-E, Texas. So I'll read that to you here, that little poem here, I guess you would call it here a poem, or this word about the Lord here, written by Anonymous, and then submitted by Wayne Hudson. So, all right, so before you get started on all that, I'd like to greet you as always. In the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who is the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sin of the world, and he too can be your Lord and Savior today, if he's not already. And that's the most important thing you can ever do, is trust Jesus and believe on him, and he'll wash away all your sin and give you eternal life, and then he'll show you and guide you and direct you in all truth as you desire to live for him each and every day of your life as a believer in Christ and all that. So, and it's all found in God's Word. So open it up and read it and study it and all that, and have a good solid relationship with the Lord. And that's something we all can learn to do better. So amen. All right, so we're going to go through the scripture song first from Ephesians 4, verse 32. And let's go ahead and look at Ephesians chapter 4 and try to get some entirety of this particular chapter here. And the book of Ephesians is a good book, just like all the books in the Bible are. So let's go here and look at Ephesians chapter 4 really quick. And let's see here. So chapter 4 is 32 verses. And verse 32 is the scripture song verse. So let's go ahead and we'll read the entirety of the chapter really quick. And then we'll get into the scripture song singing. So here it says in verse 1 of chapter 4. Says, I therefore, the prisoner of the Lord, beseech you that ye walk worthy of the vocation wherewith ye are called. And this is Paul speaking to us through the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit speaking through Paul, I should say, giving him the words to say here. And verse 2 says, continuing on, it says, with all lowliness and meekness, with long suffering, forbearing one another in love, endeavoring to keep the unity of the Spirit and the bond of peace. There is one body and one Spirit, even as ye are called in one hope of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in you all. But unto every one of us is given grace unto But unto every one of us is given grace according to the measure of the gift of Christ. Wherefore, he saith, when he ascended up on high, he led captivity captive, and gave gifts unto men. Now that he ascended, what is it but that he also descended first into the lower parts of the earth? He that descended is the same also that ascended up far above all heavens, that he might fill all things. And he gave some apostles, and some prophets, and some evangelists, and some pastors and teachers, for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, till we all come in the unity of the faith, and of the knowledge of the Son of God, unto a perfect man, unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ, that we henceforth be no more children tossed to and fro and carried about with every wind of doctrine by the sleight of men and cunning craftiness whereby they lie in wait to deceive, but speaking the truth in love may grow up into him in all things, which is the head, even Christ, from whom the whole body fitly joined together and compacted by that which every joint supplieth, according to the effectual working in the measure of every part, maketh increase of the whole body unto the edifying of itself in love. This I say therefore, and testify in the Lord, that ye henceforth walk not as other Gentiles walk in the vanity of their mind, having the understanding darkened, being alienated from the life of God through the ignorance that is in them because of the blindness of their heart, who being past feeling have given themselves over unto lasciviousness to work all uncleanness with greediness. But ye have not so learned Christ, if so be that ye have heard him and have been taught by him, as the truth is in Jesus, that ye put off concerning the former conversation the old man, which is corrupt according to the deceitful lusts, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind, and that ye put on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness. Wherefore, putting away lying, speaking every man truth with his neighbor, for we are members one of another. Be ye angry and sin not, let not the sun go down upon your wrath, neither give place to the devil. Let him that stole steal no more, but rather let him labor, working with his hands the thing which is good, that he may have to give to him that needeth. Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth, but that which is good to the use of edifying, that it may minister grace unto the hearers. Amen. And grieve not the Holy Spirit of God, whereby ye are sealed unto the day of redemption. Let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice, and be ye kind one to another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake hath forgiven you. So putting off one thing and putting on another thing. So it's not just enough to put something off, but to put the other thing on, and that would be the stuff of God. So amen. All right, so good chapter there in its entirety. And I would put that aside now, and we'll do the scripture song for today from verse 32 of chapter 4. And we'll sing along with Brother Dean and Sister Patty. And then we'll move on to
Ephesians 4:32.
Baptist bread.
And be ye kind one to another.
That's right.
Tenderhearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake hath forgiven you.
And be ye kind one to another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake hath forgiven you. Be ye kind one to another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake hath forgiven you. Forgiven you. Amen. All right, so put that back to yesterday's, if I can get it back to that particular one. All right. There we go. All right, so we'll do these again towards the end of the broadcast, yesterday's and today's again. Now it's time to move into today's topic, titled He is With Us. But let's go ahead and look at Isaiah 43 in its entirety, including verse 2, which is the passage for today, so we can get some context of the chapter and realize that not everything is written to us, but everything is written for us. And the Old Testament is mainly for the nation of Israel, but we can always apply things to our lives in these Old Testament verses and chapters here in practical ways and spiritual ways. So let's go ahead here and look at Isaiah, what was it again, 43. All right, so it was Isaiah 43, went too far there. Okay, so chapter 43, and let's see here, how many verses are here? There's 28 verses, so let's see, we won't read the entirety of the chapter, but we'll go through and we'll read verses 1 through 7, and then verse 8 starts a new paragraph, but it's good to read the whole entirety of the chapter, but we won't do that today, so you can read the rest of it on your own time. So we'll read verses 1 through 7, including verse 2, which is the passage, the verse in the topic for today. So chapter 43 and verse 1 says, But now thus saith the Lord that created thee, O Jacob, and he that formed thee, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeem thee. I have called thee by thy name. Thou art mine. When thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee. And through the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned, neither shall the flame kindle upon thee. For I am the Lord thy God, the Holy One of Israel, thy Savior. I gave Egypt for thy ransom, Ethiopia and Seba for thee. Since thou wast precious in my sight, thou hast been honorable, and I have loved thee. Therefore, while I give men for thee and people for thy life, fear not, for I am with thee. I will bring thy seed from the east and gather thee from the west. I will say to the north, give up, and to the south, keep not back. Bring my sons from far and my daughters from the ends of the earth, even every one that is called by my name, for I have created him for my glory. I have formed him, yea, I have made him. And that's the first 7 verses there. And then continue on there in the rest of the chapter. You can read that on your own there. So that gives you a little idea who God's speaking to particularly there. And now let's go ahead and get into the topic for today, titled He is With Us, for this 9th day of July, Tuesday. And again, Isaiah 43:2 says, when thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee, and through the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned, neither shall the flame kindle upon thee. Isaiah 43:2. And again, this is written by Anonymous and then submitted by Dr. Wayne Hudson from Azle, Texas. That's Azle, Texas. And he writes here, and starts here. Let's read this in its entirety, best I can. So it says here, is there any heart discouraged as it journeys on its way? Does there seem to be more darkness than there is a sunny day? Oh, it's hard to learn the lesson as we pass beneath the rod, that the sunshine and the shadow serve alike the will of God. But there comes a word of promise, like the promise of the bow, that however deep the waters, they shall never overflow. When the flesh is worn and weary, and the spirit is depressed, and temptations sweep upon it like a storm on ocean's breast, that there's a haven ever open for the tempest-driven bird. There's a shelter for the tempted in the promise of the word. For the standard of the spirit shall be raised against the foe, and however deep the waters, they shall never overflow. When a sorrow comes upon you that no other soul can share, and the burden seems too heavy for the human heart to bear, there is one whose grace and comfort, if you'll give him an abode, there's a burden bearer ready, if you'll trust him with your load. For the precious promise reaches to the depths of human woe, that however deep the waters, they shall never overflow. When the sands of life are ebbing, and I near the Jordan shore, when I see its waters rising, and I hear its billows roar, I will reach my hand to Jesus, in his bosom I will hide, and 'twill only be a moment till I reach the other side. It is then the fullest meaning of the promise I shall know, when thou passest through the waters, they shall never overflow. And that again is Anonymous, submitted by Dr. Wayne Hudson, Azle, Texas. So, good little poem there. Amen. All right, so that's the end of the little poem there, topic for today. And I'll put that aside there and move on to the Daily Strength Volume 2 book by Douglas D. Stauffer and Andrew B. Ray, as we're continuing through this week on laughter. And today is day 157, Tuesday, titled A Mouth Filled with Laughter. And Psalm 126, 1 through 3 is the passages here. So let's look and see who the psalmist is really quick, if there is a psalmist for this particular psalm here. So what was it, 126? All right, so 126, there's only 6 verses here. So I might as well read the entirety here of this chapter. Here it says Psalm 126, a song of degrees, and we'll read the first three verses along with verses 4 through 6 also. So it says here, when the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion, we were like them that dream. Then was our mouth filled with laughter, and our tongue was with singing. Then said they among the heathen, the Lord hath done great things for them. The Lord hath done great things for us, whereof we are glad. Turn again our captivity, O Lord, as the streams in the south. They that sow in tears shall reap in joy. He that goeth forth and weepeth, bearing precious seed, shall doubtless come again with rejoicing, bringing his sheaves with him. So that's the entirety of the psalm. And so now let's go ahead and get into the topic here. We read the entirety here. So this is titled again, A Mouth Filled with Laughter. And Psalm 126, 1 through 3 is the passage there, particularly for this topic today. So now introductory thoughts. It says here, the Old Testament shows God's people, the Jews, repeatedly turned from God and worshipped idols. Because of their sinful ways, they spent a considerable amount of time in captivity. Each time they turned back to God, he was faithful to bring them out of their times of captivity. Today's passage details one of those times when the people found joy in God's deliverance. The Bible testifies that their mouths were filled with laughter and their tongues with singing. The heathen took note and said, "The Lord hath done great things for them." When God did something special for his people, the overflowing emotions turned to laughter. They were grateful to God for his unmerited goodness to them, and it was manifested in that their mouths were filled with laughter. Christians should likewise be glad when God pours out his manifold blessings by delivering from physical or spiritual captivity. So, amen. All right, so good introductory thoughts there. And now for devotional thoughts. It says here for children, and we can apply this in many ways to everyone, adults also. It says Psalm 107:22b tells us to declare his works with rejoicing. Jesus gave his disciples power over many things, and they rejoiced in that power. It was good to rejoice over this power, but Jesus told them the best thing to rejoice over was the fact that their names were written in heaven. Luke 10:20b, the second part of verse 20. And now for everyone, when is the last time you were so grateful for the goodness of God in your life that you rejoiced, perhaps with laughter? How could this affect the world around you? Do you at times laugh over things that would displease the Lord, and additionally fail to rejoice when God gives you some special blessing? If so, what does this say about your walk with the Lord? So good questions to meditate on and ask yourself. So, all right, so that was the devotional thoughts. And now for prayer thoughts. First prayer thought says, ask the Lord to help you find laughter in the right things. And then ask God to give you joy in knowing him. And then the hymn today is titled Heavenly Sunlight from the book. And that'll be the second hymn today. And I could not find an instrumental or the family singing this particular first hymn today. So I'll just read you the stanzas and give you the story behind it and all that. And so here we go. Grab the hymn book here. And this one is hymn 797. And the Psalms and Hymns and Spiritual Songs book. And this is another one of these, The Suffering of the Saint Hymns, a spiritual song, titled The Cross with Patience Deign. That's D-E-I-G-N. And this is by Michael Sattler, who lived from 1495 to 1527, translated by John J. Overholt, 1918 to 2000. And then from Leader, that's G-E-I-S-T-L-I-C-H-E, that's the first name there, and Leader is the last name, it's L-I-E-D-E-R, who lived from lived in 1535. I'm not sure if that's a person or if that's a hymn book or song book there. So here's the stanzas here. There is no story for this one. So just the stanzas and then the references. And then we'll move on to the second hymn. So stanza one says, "When Christ with his true teaching came, he taught the band his gathered in." Let me reread that. "When Christ with his true teaching came, he taught the band he gathered in, that each the cross with patience deign to daily carry after him." 2. "Christ said, my dear disciples, here you shall always be vigilant, and in the earth love nothing dearer than me, my word obedient." Stanza 3. "The world upon you will unloose and cast revilement, insult to disperse you, saying in excuse that Satan dwelling has in you." Stanza 4. "When men you now revile, disdain, for my sake persecute and smite, be joyful, your reward and gain at heaven's throne I will requite." Stanza 5. "Behold me, I, the Son of God, at all times have been doing good. Most innocent these ways I trod, and yet at last they shed my blood." Stanza 6. "O Christ, thy people help alway, who follow faithful after thee, that through thy bitter death they may from all their need redeemed be." And then stanza 7. "Praise to thee, God, in thy great throne, and to thine own beloved Son and Holy Spirit praise, through whom be many to thy kingdom drawn." So, amen. All right, now the references here. So, stanza 1, we have Mark 8:34 and Luke 9:23. Stanza 2 is 1 Peter 5:8-9 and John 15:9-14. Stanza 3 is John 15:18 and Matthew 12:24. Stanza 4 is John 15:21 and Luke 6:23. Stanza 5 is John 8:29 and John 15:25. Stanza 6 is John 16:33 and Revelation 5:9-10. And then stanza 7 is 1 John 5:7 and John 16:13. So that's the end of the first hymn. And now we're going to go back a little ways to the second hymn titled Heavenly Sunlight. And so let me turn this back on here. All right, so this is titled Heavenly Sunlight. And this is hymn 636 in the Psalms and Hymns and Spiritual Songs book. And this is one of these, the Joy of the Saint hymns, a spiritual song, written by Henry J. Zelli, who lived from 1859 to 1942. And then George H. Cook, unknown to 1948. And there is no story for this one. So let me press play here and we'll sing along with the instrumental. So here we go. My journey over the mountain through the deep vale. Jesus has said, I'll never forsake thee, promise divine that never can fail. Heavenly sunlight, heavenly sunlight, flooding my soul with glory divine. Hallelujah. I am rejoicing, singing his praises, Jesus is mine. Shadows around me, shadows above me, never conceal my Savior and guide. He is the light, in him is no darkness, ever I'm walking close to his side. Heavenly sunlight, heavenly sunlight, flooding my soul with glory divine. Hallelujah, I am rejoicing, singing his praises, Jesus is mine. In the bright sunlight, ever rejoicing, pressing my way to mansions above, singing his praises, gladly I'm walking, walking in sunlight, sunlight of love. Heavenly sunlight, flooding my soul with glory divine. Hallelujah, I am rejoicing, singing his praises, Jesus is mine. Praise the Lord. Amen for that. All right, good hymn there. And now let me give you the references, and then we'll move on to the scripture songs again. So we have here stanza 1 is Romans 8, 38 through 39, Hebrews 13, 5. Stanza 2 is James 1, 17, and 1 John 1, 5. And then stanza 3 is Philippians 3, 13 through 14, and Ephesians 5, 27. And then for the refrain, we have one reference here, Philippians 4, 4. So that's the end of today's hymns. And let's put this to tomorrow's hymn here. And put that there. Oh, don't want to close that yet. All right, so now let's go ahead and do the scripture songs one more time. And then we'll wrap it up after that. So yesterday was the 8th. And 1 John 4, 7 through 8. All right, so let's do that.
1 John 4, 7 and 8.
Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God, and everyone that loveth is born of God, and knoweth God. He that loveth not, knoweth not God, for God is love. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God. And everyone that loveth is born of God, and knoweth not God, knoweth not God, for God is love. Beloved, let us love one another, 1 John 4:7-8. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God. And everyone that loveth is born of God, and knoweth God. He that loveth not, knoweth not love, for God is love. Beloved, let us love one another, 1 John 4:7-8. Amen. All right, now I kind of messed up a little bit there. So let's do today's one more time.
Ephesians 4:32. And be ye kind one right to another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake hath forgiven you.
And be ye kind one to another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake hath forgiven you. And be ye kind one to another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake hath forgiven you. Forgiven you. Amen and praise the Lord.
Hebrews 11.
All right, so don't want to do that one yet. That's tomorrow's. All right, so that's about it for today's broadcast. But before I go, let me give you tomorrow's scripture song, and then the topics for the Baptist Bread, and then the Daily Strength Volume 2 scripture verse for tomorrow, because tomorrow is a church night, so no actual topic for tomorrow, and then the hymn for tomorrow. And we might have to do another hymn if there's no instrumental for that first one there. So tomorrow is the 10th, and Hebrews 11:6 is the passage, and we'll go through the entirety of Hebrews 11. It's a good chapter there on the Heroes of the Faith chapter there. And so verse 6 says, "But without faith it is impossible to please him, for he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him." So that's verse 6 of chapter 11. And then the Baptist bread for tomorrow will be titled Spiritual Spiritual Cataracts. All right. So Spiritual Cataracts in John 9:25 is the passage. And we'll look at, John chapter 9 and get some context there. And tomorrow's author is G.W. That would be the initials for G.W. Let's see, that would be the initials for Gary Waddell, evangelist from Victory Ministries, Hartsville, Tennessee. So he's the author tomorrow. And that's for the 10th, July 10th, Wednesday, 2024. And so that's that. And then the Daily Strength Volume 2 book. No devotional for tomorrow, but I'll give you the reference that we have here. So this is day 158, church night, as we're continuing through the subject on laughter. And Luke 6:21 and 25. We'll read those passages there, and then we'll get some context there of what's going on there, other than those two verses there. But those two verses are talking about laughter particularly. So, but we'll get some context there of what's going on in those verses from Luke 6. So that's tomorrow's scripture verses there. And so we're going over this topic on laughter this week. So that's that. And then the hymn for tomorrow. We only have one hymn, but might have to pick another one if there's no instrumental for this particular hymn. And so this is going to be hymn 798 in the Psalms and Hymns and Spiritual Songs book. And this is titled Blessed Souls Which Suffer Shame. And this is another one of these, the Suffering of Saint Hymns, a spiritual song written by Samuel Medley, and then attributed to Ignaz J. Pleyel, and that's Ignaz, that's their first name, and then initial J, and then Pleyel is their last name, Pleyel, and then this is from the Presbyterian hymnal, so no story for this one tomorrow, so hopefully there's an instrumental. If not, we'll try to pick another one. It's the second hymn. So this is the hymn book here, the dark blue cover. And there's also a lighter bluish, grayish cover, and then a brown cover to the hymn books there, whichever one you prefer to have, whichever color. And then there's also a leather-bound edition. And then there's this type of side backing here, the spiral type of backing, which would replace this type of backing for the book. So whichever one you prefer to have, or you can get one of each. So that's hymn book there. And then the Daily Strength Volume 2 book. This is the cover to that book. And there's four volumes to this series of books. And you can get all those books on melodypublications.com. This is the website for those books. And then the Scripture Song book and CDs, they're available online at www.dailyscripturesongs.com. That's Brother Dean and Sister Patty Runyon's website, missionaries to Port Kaituma, Guyana. So pray for them. And Sister Patty's there now with a bunch of people helping her with VBS this week. And so pray for that VBS over there going on in Guyana. And then also pray for the VBS that started today at the Bible Baptist Church. We got through day one. And it turned out to be a good day. Praise the Lord that the rain held off. And hopefully the kids learned something from God's Word. And today the topic was on creation and all that. So that was the topic for day one. And so we got three more days left. Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. So pray for the rest of the week. And that more kids would come and invite their friends and all that. And pray for the workers as we're continuing to get the gospel and the Word of God out to these young ones, and that they take something with them, and maybe some would get saved and come to trust Jesus as our Savior. So pray for the rest of the week on that, and amen. So that's that there, the Scripture Song book and CDs, and how you can get those, and then the Baptist bread book. This is the cover for July and August, and if you order now, you might still be getting this one particularly, and that's at baptistbread.com or www.timgreenministries.org. And the second website has other books available to order. If you see anything you like on that website, if you go visit that website, that is. So that's that information for the Baptist Bread. And then the Bible, the King James Bible, the Word of God. This is the first book we need to be getting into and reading it and studying it and showing thyself approved unto God, a workman that needed not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth and searching the scripture and asking God to help you and guide you as you go into prayer and have a good solid relationship with Him each and every day and walk in the Spirit. That's the Holy Spirit. Let the Holy Spirit guide you and direct you and not to be living after the flesh and all that. So trying to live more Christ-like each and every day. And I know it's a battle each and every day battling with this flesh, but keep it crucified and dead and buried. So that's that. And then that's the Bible there. And then the other broadcasts I've been doing, where I've been reading Brother James's book on the book of Genesis here. And this is a devotional type of commentary, the only one he's ever done in this type of format, where he has different outlines and topics for each day of the year. And we've come to this ninth day of July, and this is from Genesis 27:12, and it says, "I shall seem to him as a deceiver," so talking about not deceiving people and all that. So, and did that recording already, so you can check that out either on Facebook or YouTube. And if you missed that topic today or haven't watched it yet, if you want to go back and watch any of the other ones from the first of the year up until now, you're welcome to do that by going and either scrolling down on Facebook and looking up that way, or easier yet would be go to YouTube and check them out on that YouTube page that I have, and that's Ambassador for Christ Broadcasting, or typing in Baptist Bread Broadcast and look it up that way, and like and subscribe and hit that notification bell so you know when I'm posting these up there. And this is all God's Word, teaching, preaching God's Word from different men through these devotionals, and Brother James and Brother Stauffer and Brother Ray in their devotional books. So all truth from God's Word, and hope it'll help you and be edifying to you and encourage you to keep going, and hope you learn something from these things for these books. So, and then the hymns and the scripture songs from Brother Dean and Sister Patty, and then these hymns from men and women past and from the past, old time gospel hymns. So amen. And that's that book there, and you can find these books at www.jameswknox.org, or you can go straight to the store part of the website, which is store.jameswknox.org, and look up all his books and other materials, including preaching and teaching of God's Word, both video and audio, on the church website. Or you can go straight to the YouTube channel, which is James Knox Sermons YouTube channel, and that's the church YouTube channel there for sermons from Brother James and other men that teach and preach in the, through God's Word when Brother James is not in town, and during the Sunday school hours, so during each Sunday morning there. So that's, I believe that's about it. And so continue to pray for the BBS and all that. And Lord willing, see you all next time. So thanks for watching, and bye-bye for now.